Chapter 5, Pursue Your Passion.
The next tool I would like to share with you is pursue your passion. Everyone has a bent. Everyone has a leaning. God created everyone with something that he placed in their heart as a passion. Something that you do, quite honestly, very naturally. Something that you don't even have to work at doing. You were fearfully and wonderfully made. In other words, there was a design that went into making you. You're a masterpiece. And a part of that masterpiece is a specific gift, a specific talent. And I like to liken this to a car manufacturer. You see, every car has an owner's manual. God owns your manual, and he knows what would it take to have you run at the optimal levels and at the optimal speeds to accomplish the optimal good. If I sought out to be a ballerina, no matter how hard I tried, no matter how much I practiced, I wouldn't be successful at it. I just don't have the physiology for it. I don't have the passion for it. It's just not what I was made to do. Or if I tried to be a country singer, it's just not something that I'll excel at because it's not what I was made to do. I was made to do what I'm doing right now, and that is to encourage people to pursue the things that God has called them to pursue. George Washington Carver was a man who pursued his passion. In fact, George Washington Carver created over 300 ways to use a peanut. Peanut butter, peanut hair gel, peanut lotion, peanut soap. That's a lot of peanuts. Exactly. But he had a passion for it. And he also had a passion for God. One day he asked God, he said, God, I want to understand your mind. And God said, you know what? I'm going to allow you to understand the mind of a peanut. And so he feels as though God opened up all of the mysteries of the peanut. And he began to study the peanut. He began to learn everything about it. He began to invent and create all the things that he had to learn about a peanut. And today, a lot of the things that we benefit from now is a result of George Washington Carver's work. Most people die at age 25, but they're buried at age 65. What's that? Yes, most people, they die at the age of 25. They stop living. They just start existing. There's this drastic difference of people that live to the full and people that actually do all that God's called them to do. Today, ask yourself, are you living or are you merely surviving? Mark Twain once said, find a job that you love and you'll never have to work again. Wouldn't that be great? Are you doing what you absolutely love to do? If money was not an issue, what would you find yourself doing? Would it be your current job position or would it be a different job position? Many people, they find themselves chained down to their jobs because they are seeking security, but they're not happy. God wants us to be happy. He wants us to pursue the things that he's called us to do because God has a specific path, a specific trajectory that if we should follow it, we will accomplish all the things that he's called us to do. As you pursue your passions, you cannot allow failure to hold you back. Did you know that before becoming America's favorite housewife, Lucille Ball was known as the B-movie queen? In other words, she didn't play in the mainstream movies of that day. Did you know that Abraham Lincoln, he failed 12 times before he succeeded as the president of the United States? Did you know that Beethoven's music teacher said that he was a hopeless composer, that he had no future? Did you know that Thomas Edison failed 2,000 times before he was successful at creating a light bulb? Did you know that Steven Spielberg was kicked out of University of Southern California's film school because his grades weren't good enough? Look at him now. He's one of the best producers in all of Hollywood. Did you know that Brandy, the singer, was told that she was too ugly to become an actress? Did you know that Michael Jordan did not make his freshman high school basketball team? Now look at him. He's won over 7 NBA championships. He pursued his passion. In 1962, Decca Records dismissed 4 young musicians saying that guitar music is on its way out. You know what their names were? The Beatles. Did you know that Colonel Sanders was 65 years old before he fried his first piece of chicken? Did you know that Luther Vandross was booed off the Apollo stage not once, not twice, but 3 times? He continued to pursue his passion. Did you know that Walt Disney was told that no one would ever pay to be entertained by a mouse? I bet you they're kicking themselves right now because Mickey Mouse, in fact, is the number one recognizable icon in the entire world. Most great people have attained their greatest success just one step beyond their greatest failure. Failure is not falling down, but failure is refusing to get up. You can't give up. You have to continue to pursue your passion. You can't allow yourself to get knocked down. And just because you're knocked down, that doesn't mean you're knocked out. That's because you feel like you don't have what it takes. Guess what? Never give up. Never give up.